Okay, so let's first start with who I am.
I am actually a pharmacist back home, but not a not licensed here to work. So my enthusiasm and my passion to science who drive me to come here, and I pursue my PhD in University of Georgia. And then after a PhD, you have a kind of a transition state, which is a postdoctoral fellowship, and that's what I'm doing now. I joined the physiology department 3 years ago, and the kind of research I'm doing, we're studying stroke and diabetes.
As I said, diabetes induces or aggravates a stroke, one of the risk factors of a stroke, and on the other hand, also it aggravates the outcome of the stroke. So we are trying to find why that happened, what's the mechanism that happened, and my project mainly focuses on what are the cellular mechanisms that leads to this deterioration in diabetic patient when compared to just normal stroke patient.
This is our cell culture hood. So what you need in a cell culture works is just everything to be clean, even sterile clean. So this is a filter where it circulates the air and filters inside. So even you have a different lab coat than the animal room, you have a clean animal coat, you put on your gloves and you work inside and everything of our body outside. Just work with your hand after spraying alcohol cleaning inside, and then this is the incubator where we keep our cells. We have one plate of the cells here inside, and as I said, I'm working with the vascular unit, so I'm interested in the endothelial cells. I isolate those endothelial cells from the brain, do the experiment on them, and try some medication to see on that.
Okay. So, as a part of my personality, this isn't me. I like to do research. The research is doing asking a question and try to find the answer. And if this answer can help a person, you might know. It's really like, as I said, I'm a research addict.
Doing a pharmacist will be doing the same every day. But research, we have up and down. You don't have any routine schedule. That's what I ran from my job or my previous job. But in research, you have a lot. You have your lab work, your writing work. You have a conference, which is very amazing. You have to go and publish to show the people your work. This is all like, I like it. Traveling, it's not much, by the way, but it's at least 2 or 3 times a year to different parts of the United States to present your work, national and international.
I remember like last November, I didn't go myself, but my boss took my work and presented in Japan in an international conference for endothelin.
That's really cool.
I was proud, yeah, I was proud, and she came back with all those gifts from Japan and stuff like that. I liked a lot, but it's some kind of amusing and no routine in our work.
Do you work with colleagues, or do you do this project all on your own?
No, you don't do science on your own. It's just a collaboration. We have some collaboration with neuroscience here in the Medical College of Georgia, and neuroscience. And we have also collaboration with Dr. Susan Fagan. She's in the University of Georgia. She does a stroke a lot. And it's some kind of a collaborative project. They know our technique. They taught to us, and then we do the same for them. If we have a new tool, for example, we have some kind of a hypoxia chamber where we simulate what happens to the stroke patient on a cellular level. So we also share that with them, and it's kind of a collaboration between a scientist, a physician, and pharmacist.
So to conclude, is there anything that you can say that would help others who are considering what to do with their lives and who like medicine or science or computer programming or math or to consider medical research as a career? What would you say to help encourage them to do that?
I think the same question every day for my kid. I have a 4-year-old kid and he's playing with his toys every day. I look at him, I want him to be an MD. And then I think for the same question you asked it now, do I need to push him for this career? No. I will leave it for him. If he like it, he will go for it. And he will persist and prove himself in that. So
to do a research, you have to be, as I said, a research addict. You love what you do so you can complete it. Because every day you have a disappointment, you have to carry on. If you don't have this enthusiasm inside you, no, you won't do it. Thank you.